it was offensive transition by the 66ers, getting out and getting up the court and getting easy buckets.
Yeah, they shot 58% in the opening quarter, 11 of 19. A couple of subs out there for the Toros. As Carldell Squeaky Johnson joined out there by Lewis Clinch, David McClure, Alonzo G, and Okasun. Tulsa's got it at the offensive end to our right. Out it goes to Clinch. He shoots the three. Check that. It was Cecil Brown over Clinch, and he scores. His second three of the game, he's got 10.
Yeah, I was watching him before the game in his warm-ups. He shot the ball really, really well during their warm-ups.
Squeaky Johnson, checked by the taller Yemi Agunye, and knocked out of bounds. Touch last by the Toros.
Well, the 66ers have definitely come out with a different energy and attitude tonight. So you can see in the score, but you can definitely see in their play. They're all over the place. They're active hands. They're active with their feet. They're going to run the same play here, getting Clark on the block, it looks like.
Shakur, checked by Squeaky Johnson. 12 on the shot clock. 6-point lead for the 66ers. Clark finds Agunye, shoots the three. It's no good. And the rebound taken by David McClure. Gives to Squeaky. Squeaky up the left side of the floor. Matched up against Shakur at the three-point line. Off to Okasun, right back to Carldell Squeaky Johnson. Toros down 28-22 early in the second quarter. Johnson, foul line extended left. Overplayed to his right by Yemi Agunye. Gives to Alonzo G. Lost the defender, shoots, and connects. Somebody left Alonzo G wide open.
Yeah, it was Mustafa Shakur got caught down there on him in the mismatch, and he tried to get an offensive foul, and he bailed out with the flop there. Alonzo G caught it, had the good presence of mind to keep going and going into a shot. Nice rhythm, nice shot.
On the curl, here's Brown's shot. No good. Fight for the rebound. Toros have it. They'll race out. Squeaky Johnson, dreadlocks flopping around as he crosses midcourt. Squeaky will back it up. Waits for a screen. He's double-teamed out high to Clinch. Sets and fires for three, and it's good.
Close Clinch. That was a nice set play by Squeaky Johnson. Used the pick and roll. As Okasun rolled down, Lewis Clinch's man had to help on the roll, left Lewis Clinch open for the three.
Shakur penetrates to Harden, reverse layup, missed it from point-blank range.
That's what we were talking about the other night. Okasun didn't block the shot, but just Harden knowing Okasun was in the area and he's the shot blocker made him hesitate, almost travel, and miss the layup.
Alonzo G draws a foul on Tulsa. So would you rather see Harden go up and try to flush that one than try to flip it off the glass like that?
I think anybody would, but Okasun's a good shot blocker. You know, he has good timing, good rhythm to his block shots, but, you know, Harden's playing well. He's flushed a few of them, and I wouldn't doubt that he gets another chance, so he'll attempt it.
Last foul on Cecil Brown, his first substitution as Mullins re-enters the game. Keith Clark goes to the bench. Tough screen by Okasun. Squeaky down the lane. His runner's good.
That was a great finish by Okasun, but an even better pick by Okasun. Augustine Okasun came running into the pick and roll and switched his angle in the pick and roll at the last second, which really confused his defender, Harden. Harden didn't know which way to help, and Squeaky Johnson got a chance to go down the lane uncontested.
Shakur gets down the lane and aggressively goes to the rack and lays it in.
That was a good move. Squeaky Johnson tried to pressure at half court. Mustafa Shakur made a good dribble move and got to the basket strong and finished even stronger.
He doesn't look like a guy who's that strong, but he has, you know, this uncanny way of continuing to get to the basket time and time again.
Yeah, it's one of his attributes that made him player of the year when he was in high school and helped him at Arizona. He's a wiry, strong kind of guy, but he's really, really talented, can get where he wants to get to on the court with the ball.
Shot clock winding down. Clinch banks it up and in, and he's fouled.
Lewis Clinch doing the job off the bench from the outside and driving on the inside, much to the dismay of Cecil Brown. He's holding his hands up. He can't believe the foul's called on him. Oh, it was called on Shakur, I believe, was it?
Well, they're showing Cecil Brown on the scoreboard, but I'm not sure who they're going to give that one to.
Replay looks like Cecil Brown. You see the great hesitation move? Yeah, it's Cecil Brown.
Yeah, that's number two on him. Free throw up and good. So Lewis Clinch, 11 first half points. Four of six shooting from the floor in 7 minutes and hitting that free throw. Here's Mitch Johnson into the game. The guard out of Jarvis Christian nearly has his pocket picked by Squeaky. Shot clock down to seven. Whistle and a foul on Clinch at the 3-point line.
Squeaky must have a, I don't know, a tell on Mitch Johnson or something. It's, you know, last night you saw Squeaky Johnson pick Mitch Johnson's pocket at half court, and then tonight he almost gets another one as soon as Mitch Johnson checks in the game.
So you think they got tells like poker players?
I don't know if it's a tell or something or a weak handle.
Mitch Johnson passes it over to Mullins, who lays it up and in, cutting to the basket. Nice move by Byron Mullins, and an even better pass.
Definitely, that's what the 66ers want to see from Mullins. Good set and pick. You know, he dove to the basket, had good hands catching it and finishing it. Great play.
McClure kicks it out, Squeaky for three, no good. Offensive rebound, Dwayne, and he misses the reverse shot, a little bit frustrated with himself. And Tulsa brings it up, game tied at 32. Long lead pass for Harden, he couldn't handle it. And it goes out of bounds, nearly hitting one of the Capital City Dancers, which is a no-no.
Definitely a no-no in Austin. You don't want to do that.
No.
I think they hit back.
Yep. You don't want to take on the Capital City Dancers.
Yeah.
So Squeaky Johnson brings it up, joined out there by McClure, Dwayne Jones, Lewis Clinch, and Russell Carter back into the game. Got a little zone defense look here, Malik.
No, it's man-to-man. They're running that 1-4 set against the foul line to bring everybody away from the basket.
Dwayne Jones on the baseline, back to the basket against Mullins. Jump hook over Mullins, around and out. And the rebound by McClure, another chance for the Toros. Good hustle by David McClure. Squeaky tries to penetrate. Cut off by Mitch Johnson. Squeaky gets a screen, uses it, dribbles to his left on the baseline. Kicks it out. Here's a three from Clinch. No good. And Clinch chases down his own miss. Deep in the left corner, another three. Got it!
Lewis Clinch, not bashful at all. He's had the hot hand coming off the bench. Misses his one rebound, misses his first three-pointer. Tracks down his own rebound. Has the presence of mind and the gall to take the next one and drill it.
Yeah. He had the temerity to pull the trigger on that one. He drained it. 35-32, timeout on the floor. 7:05 left to play, opening half. And Austin Toros basketball brought to you by AT&T. Your world delivered. NBA D-League Hoops continues in a moment. The Austin Toros, led by the shooting of Lewis Clinch, outscoring the 66ers 13-7 here in the second stanza. Clinch, 14 points in the game, including three threes. 35-32, Toros by three. Johnson with a bounce pass to Mullins, and Mullins, the seven-footer, misses it, gets his own miss, goes up, blocked by David McClure, and the rebound to Dwayne Jones. David McClure at 6'6", going up and blocking the seven-footer shot.
Definitely. Great job by David McClure helping out. Saw that Mullins had Dwayne Jones in a bad way. Came with the big block shot from behind.
And to add insult, Mullins called for a second personal foul.
That was a frustration foul because he blew two layups.
Beautiful pass inside, slam dunk Dwayne Jones. The bullet from Squeaky to Dwayne in the lane. We've seen some nice passes tonight.
Very nice.
Toros up by five. On the drive, little dish inside to Mullins, goes up and he throws it down. That was a frustration dunk. Technical foul on Mullins.
Yeah, he's getting a little frustrated. He's got to get himself under control because he's actually playing well. He's doing some good things and things that are really going to help him get noticed down here. But he can't be mouthing at the referees at this level. I mean, that doesn't even go over well at the NBA level. He doesn't want to get too many texts down here.
Do you think the technical was for hanging on the rim or for talking smack after he dunked it?
It was for talking smack after he dunked it, but he was talking smack because of the last two or three plays. He felt he got fouled a couple of times when he lost the ball. Then he got dunked on by Dwayne Jones when you said Dwayne in the lane. And now down on the other end, he makes a strong move, but it's good. Sometimes a little bit of fire like that, it's good to wake him up. I like to see him, down there using his size, his seven-foot frame down there in the paint where he can dominate as opposed to shooting jumpers at the top of the key. And if he's playing with that type of fire, that's only going to help him play better.
Squeaky Johnson joined out there by Lewis Clinch, Dwayne Jones, Justin Bowen, and Russell Carter, who has it right wing. Catch and shoot, long two, And it's off the rebound taken by Mullins. Gives to Cecil Brown. Brown, right wing, in front of the Tulsa bench to Clark. Throws the diagonal pass for Owens against Carter, backing him down. Knocked out of his hands, and the Toros have the loose ball. They'll bring it up, leading by 4:38-34 as we've crossed the midway point of the second quarter. Squeaky between his legs on the dribble, checked by Shakur. Lobs for Dwayne Jones and a whistle. And I'm not sure what that call was there, Malik.
It's an offensive foul in the post-up by Dwayne Jones, but seems like that technical has...